Good afternoon, and welcome to St. Andrew's Parish for today's Vigil Mass for the 12th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please stand.
Good afternoon. I must say it's really, really good to be with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. During the homily stage, we'll discuss what went on last Saturday. But for now, we'll remind ourselves again this weekend. We pray in a special way for all fathers. This weekend, we give to fathers. We're also reminded in the gospel today, the apostles are not happy with the Lord Jesus. Why are they not happy with him? Because he's asleep on a cushion, and there's a big storm after blowing up around the boat. And they're not happy that he was asleep, and they're worried. And we'll remind ourselves of what he said to them. He's saying to us also in the gospel today. We'll take a look at that in a few moments now. Now let's ask the Lord again to remove all the worries and the distractions from our minds. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to his people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please be seated now for the readings.
The first reading is a reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut the doors within the sea when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment and thick darkness its swaddling bands, when I set limits for it and fastened the bar of its door and said, thus far you shall come, but no farther, and here shall your proud waves be stilled, the word of the Lord.
Love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord. His love is everlasting. They who sail the sea in ships, trading on the deep waters, saw the works of the Lord and his wonders in the abyss. Give thanks to the Lord. His love is everlasting. His command raised up a storm wind, which tossed its waves on high. They mounted up to heaven, they sank to the depths. Their heart melted away in their plight. Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting. To the Lord in their distress, from their straits he rescued them. He hushed the storm to a gentle breeze, and from the billows of the sea were still. Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting. They rejoiced that they were calmed, and he brought them to their desired haven. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his kindness and his wondrous deeds to the children of men. Give thanks to the Lord, his love is everlasting.
The second reading is a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us. Once we have come to the conviction that one died for all, therefore all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh, even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh. Yet now we know him no longer. So whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. On that day, as evening drew on, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat, just as he was. And other boats were with him. A violent squall came up, and waves were breaking over the boat, so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep on a cushion. They woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this whom even the wind and the sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord. As I said at the beginning of Mass, it is good to be here, and I really mean that. Last Saturday, I got a pain, and eventually I made my way to Morton Hospital. And what did they do? But they rushed me to Good Samaritan Hospital. That's humbling. You ever on an ambulance? It's not so fun. So it's humbling because they stop all the traffic for you, you know. So I got there, and they put in two stents into an artery through my hand, and stay there overnight. I wasn't planning on having the anniversary Mass for 23 years of ordination in a hospital, but the point is, no matter where I say the Mass, it's always good. But I did notice as well, as I was just about to say Mass on Sunday, a priest comes to the door of the room, and he said, "Are you a priest?" I said, "Yeah." And I said to myself, I'm going to put him to work, because I know as a chaplain how I've been at the other side of it, administering to patients. So I said, "Anoint me, give me the anointing of the sick," which he did. And that's even very humbling. Do you realize when I anoint somebody, it's always on the forehead and in the palms of the hands. But for a priest, it's on the forehead and the back of the hands, because the priest's hands are already consecrated. So you turn them around when it's a priest. And he anointed me, and then I said to him, "Hear my confession now also." Put him to work, you know, it's good. So he did. A very nice priest, very beautiful priest, a great ministry. But I tell you that part of the story because we are now coming close to the end of Catholic Charities. And if you were ever in your local hospital here, Morton Hospital, and you saw a priest, the hospital does not pay for their salary. The chaplain's salary comes from Catholic Charities. So do give to that charity, because you know, you never know when you're going to need it. Amen? Let's now go to the homily, to the gospel. There's a story, first of all, about Brother John who joined a monastery. And when he joined, they told him, "This is a silent monastery. Is that okay with you?" And he said, "Okay." He says, "But every year on your anniversary, you can say two words." So anyway, first year went by. Brother John was summoned to the head office, And the abbot said to him, Brother John, you've been with us now one full year. You can say two words. And Brother John blurts out, hard bed. And the abbot says, okay, hopefully we can, sorry about that. We can do something about that. So anyway, time goes on. It comes to his second anniversary. Brother John is summoned to the head office again. And the abbot says to him, today is your anniversary. You've been with us two full years. You may say another two words. Brother John blurts out, bad food. The abbot says, I'm sorry about that. Hopefully we can do something about it. So 3 years go by. His third anniversary. And Brother John is summoned again to the head office. And the abbot is there. And he says again to him, Brother John, today is your third anniversary. You may say two words. Brother John blurts out, I quit. And ahead, the abbot says, you know, Brother John, I think it's all for the best. All you have done since you got here was complain. The gospel today is about complaining. What happened here in the gospel? Despite being very close to Jesus, they have no idea who he is. They are frightened despite his presence. They say he is not looking after our welfare. In response to their plea, Jesus comes to their aid and demonstrates his divine nature by controlling the elements. They don't recognize him. Who can this be, they say? A question we all have to answer for ourselves. Many times we say, who is he? Where are you? Do you care about me? Do you hear me? Is it fair, etc.? Many will try to answer and tell you who God is. But you're here today because your hearts are open. The gospel is also about trust and faith. A very wise man said, our faith grows stronger if we question it and try to strengthen it every so often. We don't always have faith. We don't always have trust in God. That's okay, because faith and doubt can live side by side. Did you ever watch a child sleeping? It's very tranquil. It's very peaceful, isn't it? They don't have a care in the world as you look at them. They're just sleeping there peacefully. In fact, to be asleep means you're not worried. If you're worried, you can't sleep. But today, the apostles didn't think that Jesus was tranquil and peaceful. They didn't see it that way, did they? In fact, he was asleep on a cushion. It's the only time, I believe, in the scriptures where you hear that. He was asleep on a cushion in the boat. That seems very beautiful, doesn't it? But to those who are worried, there's a big storm and they're afraid they're going to drown. And what do they do? Of course, they wake him up. Well, he was good enough to say to them, you know, he didn't say to them, let me alone, I want to sleep. No. He asked two questions, and we'll go through them in a few moments. But I want you to think about this.
Think about this deeply. What is silence when your poor head is so confused, like muddy water? How do you clear it? Stillness, to be still, the muddy water will sink. The water becomes clear when it is still. But do you have the patience to let the mud settle? That's the question. You see, silence, as Scripture says, be still and know that I am God. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for Him. There are two types of silence. Outward silence, when you are so in tune you can hear the birds singing. And the inner silence. The gospel, and there was great calm. Even the wind is destined to bear great fruit. You see, when he quietened the sea, the great calm is a symbol of the Holy Spirit. But he asked two questions today. Why do you doubt? Why are you fearful? And our answer is, because I don't think you're listening to me. I don't think you're with me. And yet, it's only in the silence, that God can speak to us. Look, put it another way, if an aeroplane goes over the church and you're outside, well, you can't hear the birds singing because there's too much noise. Silence. It's in the silence that God speaks to us. Mother Teresa said this, when you come, let's say you're in the chapel behind me, in front of the Blessed Sacrament, she said, half of that time should be in silence. And yet we want to go in there and say the rosary, which is good, read and read and read and read and talk and talk and talk to our head. Half the time should be in silence. Do you care that we're drowning? And he says, where do you not yet have faith? The apostles didn't have it at that time, but eventually they did learn it, didn't they? How do we know that? Because we believe 11 of the 12 gave their lives for the Lord. Let me just leave you with this. Lord, if ever comes a time I'm complaining about the things I asked for but didn't get, remind me of the things you have gave me without I praying for. Amen.
Let us now together profess our faith in one God. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God and true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the power of the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom of no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. On this Saturday afternoon, now we humbly raise our hearts, our minds, to our Heavenly Father as we bring the needs before him.
For the Church and the world, may the Lord protect her from all evil as she testifies to the good news of Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have authority over others, may God grant them grace and leading with understanding and justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who feel burdened by the storms in their lives, may the hope of Christ bring them peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and dying in this faith community, and for those who love them, may God grant them strength. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they rejoice in the presence of God in his eternal kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The Mass intentions today are offered up for Joseph M. Lazar's first anniversary. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We just pause for a moment now in the silence of your own hearts. Heavenly Father, you know the needs of all who are present here in the church, also those who are listening and watching on the airwaves. We bring all our prayers before you through the intercession of the Blessed Mother, Saint Joseph, as we say the Hail Mary together. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. My sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of consolation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours, that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We now again come to the most sacred part of the Mass, the Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Edgar our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
This is Jesus, the risen Lord, the healer. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Amen.
At this time, you can make a spiritual communion. I love you, O my God. I cannot receive you in Holy Communion. Come, nevertheless, and visit me with your grace. Come spiritually into my heart. Purify it, sanctify it, render it like unto your own. Amen.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign. Pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of death is at your side. Know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you.
Oh,
most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee, O virgins of virgins, our mother. To you do we come, before you we stand, sinful and sorrowful. O mother of the word incarnate, despise not our petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer them. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin, may the heart of Jesus in the most blessed sacrament be praised, adored, and loved with grateful affection at every moment in all the tabernacles of the world, even to the end of time. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl around the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
The Mass announcements. As of this weekend, June 19th through the 20th, Father's Day weekend, the bishop is lifting the dispensation of the Sunday and Holy Day Mass obligation. All able Catholic will be required to attend Mass. We are getting ready to bring back altar servers, lectors, and Eucharistic ministers, as well as greeters and ushers. If you are interested, there are sign-up sheets at the entrances. The choir is looking to grow as more parishioners return. They would love to have you join them in the choir. See the bulletin for more details. Tickets will go on sale this weekend for the second annual Paint Night. All proceeds will go to this year's Catholic Charities Appeal. Limited spaces are available. If you have not already done so, please consider donating to the Catholic Charities Appeal. There are pledge cards and envelopes available at all the entrances. Happy Father's Day to all fathers, grandfathers, and guardians. Thank you.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord. And again, I just want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for your prayers. They mean everything to me. Now we're going to have a prayer for all fathers. For our fathers who have given us life and love, that we may show them respect and love, we pray to the Lord. For our fathers who have lost a child through death, that their faith may give them hope, and their family and friends support and console them, we pray to the Lord. For fathers who have died, that God may bring them into the joy of his kingdom, we pray to the Lord. God our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless these men that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended now. Go in peace and love to serve the Lord. Thank you all for your presence, and may the week be one of peace and especially health. God bless you.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
Eternal Father, strong to save, whose arm has bound the restless wave, who bids the mighty ocean deep its own appointed limits keep. Oh, hear us when we raise our plea for those in peril on the sea. O Christ, the Lord of Israel,